Okay, let's call the meeting order for February the 13th, 2017, council meeting. Adoption agenda by resolution, please. Unless it's here, and then we'll have to get someone else to say.
Is it me?
Just you.
We never get this early in the show.
I went backwards tonight.
Sure did, because I got something I just...
Moved by myself, seconded by Councilor Commodore.
Commodore, yeah.
Be it resolved that the agenda be adopted as presented.
Okay, any questions on this? Call a question, all in favor? Okay, item number three, confirmation of minutes.
Moved by myself, seconded by Councilor Commodore. Be it resolved that the minutes of the regular council meeting and the minutes of the committee of the whole January 23rd, 2017 be hereby approved, all statutory declarations having been complied with.
Any discussion on these? I, of course, won't be voting. I wasn't here. So I'll just turn this over for Brian to sign. All in favor? Five, all abstain.
So 5-4, abstain. No, one abstain, and then carried.
You're about to find out the timing is everything.
The door was locked.
Oh.
I was so confused. The door is locked?
The back door.
Oh, okay.
Okay, we'll have it to come through. I take it you're Allison?
Yes.
It's your time. It's your turn.
Oh, okay.
That's what I mean. Timing is everything. Have a seat.
Do I just go up here? Okay.
Tell us your name and tell us what's going on.
All right. So my name's Allison Giardino, and I'm with a teacher at MBCI. And so we have this idea of doing a summer camp program where youth between grades 4 to grade 6 of this school year will make a mural. And so we're applying for a grant for $5,000, which isn't too much when you spend it all on art supplies. But so what we're asking is that we kind of want to make the mural for the city. So youth are making something for the town, not just something they might see in school, something that everyone can see. So we kind of are asking for support from the town for a location to put the mural, as well as installation. Because the $5,000 covers all the supplies, food, activities. We just really need somewhere to put the mural. We really want it for the town. Mm-hmm. And then to install it, because there's also like liability issues, right? Like it needs to be bolted or it needs to be on stilts so it doesn't like fall off, right? So those are something that we just don't have the resources for.
Okay, that's... it's a great idea.
Yeah.
Probably nobody in this community believes in murals more than me. I would recommend, because I don't know if you've been watching the newspapers, we're pretty broke. But that doesn't mean you can't apply for other grant money through avenues such as the Destination Marketing Fund. And we will be more than happy to help steer you in that direction.
Okay.
And that's where your best bet is going to be. To me, it's a perfect fit.
Are you just looking for a location?
Yeah, just a look, like somewhere we can put the mural. And
well,
then,
and assistance in installing.
Right. And just to get it installed.
Yeah. That's where the dollar's going to come. We can find the funds. Yeah. We can find a place for sure. But to get it installed, I know you're going to have 16 guys with hard hats and steel-toed boots and 6 years of training and the whole nine yards. So
if we get the money for pay for it to get installed, the location would be... totally fine. Like we can find somewhere to put it that's from the city.
We will work with you to find that location.
Okay, perfect. That's all I need to know.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Great.
That's everything.
Anybody else?
No.
I just want to be clear. Like we're not saying that we're going to be able to look after the installation as the town, but that if you need funds to put up the sign, that maybe the Destination Marketing Committee, there are funds available there that you could apply to the Destination Marketing Committee for funds for the installation.
But we can't like make a mural for the city, right? Like there's
And if you pick a spot for it, I would just come back to to the town and maybe brainstorm and get like a location picked before you go ahead with everything?
Yes.
Just because, I mean, I'd hate to see you measure out something and then build it, and then it's not really a suitable spot for it, or we don't own that property, or something like that, right?
Yes, yeah.
So.
Okay.
And just a bit of advice, when you do make application for that funding, make sure that you have a good solid quote in hand.
Yes.
Because afterwards, you find out it might be more, and then there's issues. So let's
eliminate
all the issues.
Okay, perfect.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
Just out of curiosity, how big is the sign?
In the breakdown, what I had budgeted was about 4x8 just on plywood, and then getting two of those, whether one would be like a rough draft, just because it'd be with younger kids, or if it would be like 4x16 or 8x8.
So they're just doing one?
Yeah, they're just doing one, but there's 10 each, so I like budgeted for two pieces of wood, just because you never know, right?
Right, but you're 2 4x8 sheets of plywood that you're talking about.
But then again, like, that's just what I looked at sizing for, but size, again, like smaller, bigger, like I'm pretty flexible, just, Awesome.
Good, wonderful. Awesome. Good luck on this.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Are the stilts still up for your vote, Councillor Gibson?
Sure.
You could just slap your all right on there.
You must work for government, 16 men in hard hats to put up 1 4x8 sheet. That's how they do it at UCN, I guess.
All right, item number 5 on the agenda is the CEO's report.
So the following is an update as it relates to various departmental reports as to February 8th. Museum hosted some school programs. They also held their Home Roots concert on the 5th. The performer was Mary Beth Carty. They are preparing for Moffitt Fund application and preparing for the opening artwork of Linda Monroe. Safety officers have been patrolling school areas as a result of parking complaints. Parking on Cook Avenue is still an issue. I must say, a lot of the parking there is coming to the second stage, which is going to the screening officer. This is taking an extreme amount of time. I'd like to publicly remind people it is 2-hour parking. Please respect the parking, otherwise you get tickets. Music Moves class started on February 7th. They're preparing for the Cordwood Bones Peel that's going to take place on Friday. There's been some brine loss for the ice at the arena. Maintenance crew was trying to resolve the issue, and I understand that the issue is now resolved, or close to resolve, that it's actually working the ice.
We're maintaining and molding.
Good job.
Yeah, we did lose some brine. We don't know where it went. So.
Okay.
Wheelchair access at the arena is now complete. Yay!
Okay.
Hot water issues at Wellness Center and Arena have now been resolved. Meetings have been held as it relates to hydro consumption for the Winton pool. This is still an ongoing issue with Kelsey School Division. Pool testing course completed with 100% pass rate. Campground office has been completely removed. We're still having issues with garbage down by the waterfront. There have been a few winter burials, however, the comb burial is being utilized more and more.
Yeah.
Public Works is working on water breaks on McDonald, Bignall, and Cathedral. There have been water and sewer line freeze-ups also as a result of the change in weather. Sidewalks and snow pier removal are ongoing, much quicker with having less snow. Leaders are being turned on, preparing for festival. I don't know if anybody's been down by the waterfront or whatever. They're pretty much done the preparations for the port. Working with Energy Advocate and finishing of HID LED tender, and also trying to have someone come in to discuss solar energy. Preparing for QP and steelworkers negotiations. Scheduled respect in the workplace training for town employees. Reviewing employee benefits program. Finance completed various year-end reports such as public sector compensation, general assistance expenditure report, and 2016 municipal grant reporting. Reviewing tax sale listing and entering into agreements for payment of tax arrears. Revamping of zoning bylaw and municipal enforcement act. Jen has spent an incredible amount of time going through the zoning bylaw and making it much more plain English, so it's a very workable document. Participated in Tourism North meeting, lots of correspondence, setting up screening officer hearings for tickets, and the fire department has responded to several calls in January and have been doing a great job and definitely keeping the CAO in the loop.
Any comments?
There is an offer made to a fire chief. We're waiting to hear back.
Okay, thank you.
We should know by the end of the week.
Fingers crossed. Very good, thank you. Item number 6.1, waste disposal bylaw.
Oh, nobody signed it. Come on. We'll get you to sign it after. Moved by myself, second by Councillor Gibb. Okay. Resolve that bylaw number 4559 being the bylaw of the town of the Paul to provide for a waste management system and to repeal bylaw number 4541, be read a second time.
Remind me why we're making these changes again. I've been away since December.
Because of the, how it happened after holidays. Christmas with holidays.
Right.
Some people go almost 2 weeks without a pickup, so we're allowing them to have more days.
I remember.
Only those who are affected, though. That doesn't mean everybody.
The 11-day rule.
Okay. All right. Any other questions? Any other inquiries? Call a question. All those in favor? Third reading, please.
Moved by myself, second by Councillor Alan Gibb, resolved that bylaw number 4559 being a bylaw of the Town of the Paul to provide for a waste management system and to repeal bylaw number 4541 be read a third time and be passed.
Okay, this is a recorded vote. Councillor Gibb?
Aye.
Councillor Ford is absent. Councillor Rock?
Aye.
Councillor Zielinski?
Aye.
Councillor Morish?
Aye.
Councillor Commodore?
Aye.
Mayor Scott? Aye. Six. It is carried. We'll have a happier Christmas. All right. 7.3.1, the invoice on the Kinsman Campground building.
Moved by myself, seconded by Councillor Commodore, whereas Council was in agreement to have the Kinsman Campground building demolished, and whereas Bar Big Lake Ranch was the successful tender and has completed the work and submitted an invoice for payment. Therefore, be it resolved that Council authorize the payment of invoice number 108680 to Bar Big Lake Ranch in the amount of $11,550 for the demolition of the Kinsman Campground building, and the money is to be expended from the Waterfront Reserve Fund.
Any discussion? Councillor Rock.
Just to be clear, this is a resolution to approve the expenditure from the Waterfront Reserve Fund. That's a basic intent, because the work was done and there was authority to do that in advance. It was just that we wanted to come from this particular fund, which requires
a resolution.
Motion of council.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
And it also means that we can no longer worry about the big liability issue that was going on there for year after year after year. Any other comments? All in favor? All right. 7.3.2, payroll and accounts.
Moved by myself, seconded by Councillor Commodore, be it resolved that Council authorize the following accounts. Pay period number one in the amount of $99,893.08. Town of the Paw checks number 18255 to 18321 in the amount of $479,332.82. Kelsey Recreation checks number 5866 to 5927 in the amount of $179,758.36. And electronic funds transfer in the amount of $97,236.20.
Any discussion? Call a question. All in favor? Okay, 7.3.3, fees for services.
Moved by myself, seconded by Councillor Rock, whereas Council requested the process for variations and conditional uses be reviewed, and when this was done, it became apparent that all fees for services required updating. And whereas comparisons, recommendations for increases, and reasons for the recommendations were provided to Council. Therefore, be it resolved that Council authorize the following fee increase for services as per attached. Do I have to read them?
No. I don't see any reason to.
Okay. Do. Unless anyone really wants to know what the changes are, I will read them. But.
It's not going to make a difference.
Oh, I just had a question with regard to the document fees for service. There didn't seem to be anywhere where it indicated that it's Town of the Paw. And when this single page gets out all on its own, it gets confusing if we don't relate it back to. Us,
so this would be attached to a bylaw, right?
The only reason is just because it's attached to the resolution.
So this is part of a bylaw?
Forms part of the resolution.
Not a bylaw.
Or sorry, part of the resolution. So that page forms part of it.
Oh, so it'll end up in the minutes like this?
It ends up in the resolution attached like that.
This gets
like any other attachment that we would
right,
put to a resolution.
Right, but when we go back to our minutes, we will not see this document.
Then. Correct.
So then...
I'll read it out. Tax certificate, $30. Zoning certificate, $50. Tax assessment, $15. Variation application, $250. Variation application approved by the CAO, $50. Conditional use application, $250. Development agreement, $200 plus legal fees. Road and public reserve closing, $500 plus legal fees. Amendment to development plan and zoning bylaw, $550. Amendment to development plan or zoning bylaw, no notices, are $500. Amendment to the development plan or zoning bylaw with notices is $550. Encroachment or easement agreement is $100. Printed copy of development plan or zoning bylaw is $25. Copy of tax statement is $5. And a copy of your water bill is $5. Anything else?
Well, still doesn't resolve my concern that we're passing a resolution where the actual content of it isn't going to be connected. When you look at it 2 months from now on our minutes, it will not, this portion of the document will not be there, I guess, is
correct,
what
just like your bylaws. All you get is the actual resolution. Every document we pass by resolution that is not form part of your minutes. It forms part of the record where we keep all the resolutions, and it forms part of the record where we keep all the bylaws. We have an actual binder that keeps those documents. They are never and have never been included in their actual minutes because they're an addendum or an attachment to the resolution. So it goes with the original resolutions.
Right, and if anyone wants to see that,
they
original
come in
resolution,
and they look at the resolution.
They come in. So I guess my concern is we're making it a labor-intensive task to get the full resolution, because this makes up part of the resolution, is what I'm understanding. Because that's in fact where we're passing. So if we don't include it in, then people have to come here and talk to people.
And they do, because generally they don't know there's a fee until we tell them. Then we tell them, here's the fee, and we show them the schedule.
Right. I just thought it would, in this day and age, it'd be simpler if we figured out a way to get that so they can just look it up for themselves when they see the minutes. Like we see it here, it's
okay. So when they go to the Town of the Paw website and they pull up the minutes for today's meeting, this is what it's going to look like. So when they get to the resolution for fees for service, they're going to click on it, and that's going to come up along with the resolution. So it's there if they want to access it electronically. If there's somebody who's not willing to access it electronically, yes, they are going to have to come into the town office. But if they want to go on the website and look at our minutes and the agendas that go with our meetings, they go to the agenda for tonight's meeting, they click on the fees for service, the resolution comes up, the attachment for the resolution comes up, and all of the information is there, and they have the same information that we do.
But just operationally speaking, for you guys, doesn't it just go on our website under fees?
This would be a list of his fees anyway. Fees.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it'll go
so
under.
So we don't.
Fees.
Why would it? I mean, from an operational point of view, if I'm coming to town to build something or do whatever, why would I go? I just go look and see what the town fees are, and I click on it.
Realistically, they usually pick up a phone and ask.
Yeah, either or. Right, but you know.
Yeah,
I think most people know there are fees associated. Yeah. They just may not know how much, and so a very short amount of time investigation will determine what that fee is. I don't think it's cumbersome or a burden in any way. My thought.
Okay.
Anything else? All those in favor? Okay. (clears throat) 7.3.4, Kelsey Recreation.
Moved by Councilor Rock, seconded by Councilor Zelensky. Whereas effective January 1, 2017, Kelsey Recreation Commission ceased operations as a commission, and whereas the Recreation Department is still owned by the town and is considered a regular department within the town, however, the department is still referred to as Kelsey Recreation. Therefore, be it resolved that Council approve Kelsey Recreation name change to the Town of the Paw Recreation Department, and use the town logo of the Town of the Paw logo.
Any discussion? Councilor Rock.
I apologize because I just went over tonight and looked and it, all our signage is Kelsey Recreation Center. Now, does that mean it'll be that name and we're This is intended to change the organizational structure, but not the name of the center?
So the actual building will, yeah, remain the Kelsey Recreation Center, but we won't have a Kelsey Recreation Commission, right?
Right.
So we'll just have a recreation department.
Yeah. Part of the problem being KRC, in my mind, was always Kelsey Recreation Commission. It was never Kelsey Recreation Center. Now it will be Kelsey Recreation Center, and the organizational structure will show it differently.
Any other inquiries?
Saved a lot of money not having to change signs.
Yes, it did.
Yeah.
Okay.
That was the whole idea behind it.
All those in favor?
Yeah.
Mr. Finney? Good. 7.3.5, ATM agreement.
Moved by myself, seconded by Counselor Morse. Be it resolved that council authorized the chief administrative officer to sign a lease agreement with the Paul Minor Hockey with regards to the lease of space for an automatic teller machine ATM to be located at the Roy H. Johnson Arena.
Any discussion? Counselor Rock?
Unfortunately, I'm troubled with the first paragraph of that, where it says, whereas the town of DePaul is the owner of the RHE Arena, is authorized to issue, comma, part of the RHE Johnson Arena described in as automatic teller machine in brackets ATM in the lobby to the Minor Hockey, the Paul Minor Hockey shall be included in this agreement. And to me, that's confusing in terms of what we do. I wasn't sure whether we're leasing an ATM or simply space. And I was given to understand it was they needed the space so they can put in an ATM.
We are authorizing the lease of space to the Paul Minor Hockey Association so that they may purchase an ATM and plug it in and earn funds from that. That's what I see there.
Right, but that's not what it says. That's all.
Part of the RH.
They're leasing.
Part of the RH Johnson Arena.
Yeah, so what that says is that the part of the building that they're leasing out is going to be known as the ATM. That's how they're describing the space that they're renting to them. We're not renting them an ATM, but it shall be described as automatic teller machine. So the space that they're leasing, the part of the RHA Johnson that they're leasing is going to be described as the automated teller machine, because they need to give that space a name. So that's what they're calling it.
I think it's 2 by 2.
Because it's not an office, right? Like, they can't just say we're renting out office 3, or we're renting the dressing room 4, or whatever, right?
It's not even that big, those things.
That's what they're going to call that space instead of calling it an office or whatever.
We're not providing the ATM. We're providing the floor space to put an ATM on.
Because it says the lessee will take full responsibility for all costs associated with the installation, operation, maintenance, and removal of the ATM, which includes the installation of a dedicated line, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
Right, they do all that.
Okay. Anything else? All in favor? Opposed, if any? There we go. Okay, 7.7, Sam Waller Museum Minutes. They are attached. We've read them. 7.8, Destination Marketing Committee. They're attached. Committee meeting. They're attached, and we've read those. We'll go on to committee reports, Museum Board. Counselor Rock?
The Museum Board has a meeting tomorrow night.
Oh, okay. Chamber of Commerce, Counselor Commodore?
Oh, I have. Yep, I do have everything. Okay, we've got the trade show going on May 13th weekend. We have a president. We have Graham. Okay, his last name just went. Keller? Yeah.
Yeah.
And Krista Tooley is our vice president.
Excellent.
So we've got a full board going. So that, and yeah, the main thing we were all talking about was the trade show and getting on that, so, which is a lot of work for a small amount of people. We're looking for a office worker because we have Shirley Barbeau. She's got too many jobs right now.
She's down to about 7 or 8 right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, no, that's about it.
Okay. Good. Sustainable Forest, Counselor Rock?
There's been no meeting, but I did attend, and Counselor Commodore attended the public meeting with regard to the two-year plan they're developing. The interesting part about that is most of the plan is relating to forest areas close to the mill, close to this area because of cost effectiveness and everything else. And they're visiting quite a number of communities around the north to get their open.
Okay, thank you. CDC, Counselor Gibb?
We had an informal meeting today in preparation for Wednesday's meeting with the Premier.
Okay. All right, Destination Marketing, Counselor Marsh. Oh, your minutes are attached, sorry.
Minutes are attached, and just so everybody knows, our committee did approve a grant application, which I did mention at the last meeting, so that's available for people to apply for money. We approved a budget, so how much we're going to give out in grants, and also we are going to do a marketing project, hopefully with the CDC. That's kind of in the works, where a couple of our board members are going to meet with a couple of their board members and see if we can't do something for marketing for the town, and do it as a joint collective thing, so that we're collectively marketing the area, and not just, you know, Trappers markets their stuff and Kinsman markets theirs and whatever. So that's where things stand right now, but there is money and a grant application available, so apply.
Okay. Recycling Board, Councillor Zelensky.
No meeting. We have a meeting scheduled for Wednesday.
Okay. Pock Community Renewal Corporation, Councillor Moore.
There was a meeting today at lunch. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to make it, but it was mostly a financial update, because our bookkeeper has been away for a month, so yeah. That was the most of the meeting, and really, things are just really on hold for them right now, because they won't find out about their funding until who knows really when, so they're kind of on, I don't know, not hiatus, but I mean, they don't know if they're going to have money to do anything next year, and their all their money runs out at the end of March, so really we're just waiting, and I hope that that's something we can put a bug in the ear to the Premier about, because they do a lot of our community development stuff, our community-oriented development stuff anyways, like, you know, help with Canada Day, and they do the street festival, and housing fix-up grants, and help to organize a lot of things and whatnot, so...
Okay, thank you. Joint Committee of Council, Councillors Commodore and Rock.
Yeah, we had a meeting. We had a very quick meeting, but we haven't had any correspondence. But that letter we put out for the fees from the lake and Rocket Lake, so we're just kind of waiting on that and working on with the RM for joint sponsorship.
Okay. Kelsey School Division, no meeting. Okay. Citizens Period, anybody?
No. Citizens on Patrol.
For me?
Citizens on Patrol.
Can I miss it on
you? Sure, Citizens on Patrol. Councillor Commodore.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Okay. No, that's okay. RCMP Liaison Officer Report, their nightly check stops. They're doing a lot more roaming patrols. They had 98.9% to 99% compliance rate. Where are we to kick? The Trappers Festival that was brought up. They want COPP members to do a little bit more patrols. I invited the public safety officer to our meeting, which everybody was extremely happy with, because there's always a lot of reports and discussions with this, that, and the other thing. So he had a lot of answers for them. And since he's been going to the public schools, he's been going to Pasco School and Kelsey School, and there's always a lot of complaints. And they were quite happy that he's trying to correct a lot of parents when he's there. And unfortunately, they actually know when he's there, and when he's not there, they're bad again.
That is not there.
Yeah.
Okay, just before we adjourn the meeting, just to remind people that Trappers Festival, the 70th version of the Trappers Festival, that's a monumental number, nothing like it in the rest of the country. And so I would ask people this year to make extra special time to go and enjoy and take in the events. And someone suggested today, I thought it was pretty good advice, that Do not speed, do not roll through intersections. Make sure you have your driver's license with you. Make sure you have insurance on your vehicle. Make sure everything is, as they say, tickety-boo, because if it's not, it will cost you. All right, so with that, I'll ask for an adjournment. Okay, Councilor Morsch, we are adjourned. All right, thank you.